Hi, this is Barry Coleman with the Northern Canola Growers Association. Thank you for attending this year's tour. The Northern Canola Growers Association has a broad representation of board members from across the state who work hard representing the industry. We allocate over $300,000 in annual research funding to strengthen the canola crop in this region. Much of the research focus has been on disease identification and control, insect management, hybrid development specific to our growing region, finding new uses for canola oil, and improving management and stand establishment. Now, the past few years have been challenging for agriculture due to the low prices for commodities. We had the market facilitation program for 2 years, which has now been replaced by the Coronavirus Food Assistance Program, or CFAP. And the canola industry is fortunate in this regard, as canola has been included in this program, unlike the USDA shutout of our crop, as well as many other crops from the market facilitation program from prior years. We're providing input to Senator Hoeven on the continued need for assistance in the way of price supports for the 2020 crop year. The CFAP announced in May of this year did provide over $17 million to the canola industry. Now, this came out to about $9 an acre, and while those in agriculture are certainly appreciative of this support for agriculture at this time, it's far short of what is needed for the problem of low prices this year. This is based off of the USDA calculating the drop in canola price from January to April of this year, and then applying a reduction factor on that when determining how much money would be allocated to growers. The ag industry has been told that the reason for the reduction of the funds was that USDA was limited by the funds they had available in the CCC, therefore the amounts need to be reduced. This points to the need for more assistance from the USDA, and Senator Hoeven's office has indicated they do indeed intend to provide more assistance. We should be hearing more in the next few weeks from the Senate in this regard. And the NCGA will continue to provide any information needed to ensure that canola gets its fair share of assistance from any future programs. Now, in addition to the CFAP program, the NCGA predicts that canola PLC payments for this year will reach the highest levels ever. Total payments will likely exceed $90 million for the canola industry. Now, North Dakota has 1.35 million base acres of canola in the program, which represents about 95% of the total canola base acres in the country. Average payments for these base acres is roughly $74 an acre. And we worked closely many years ago with the U.S. Canola Association and other canola growers from other states to ensure that canola was included in this important price support program. And it continues to provide needed financial support to canola growers in a decoupled manner. So our working with other allies and other canola growers in other regions of the country certainly paid dividends in that regard to this program. Now, some other issues that the NCGA has been working on are getting canola eligible for inclusion in renewable diesel. Back when the biodiesel program was started over a decade ago, it was found that canola met the life cycle analysis for biodiesel, but not the higher threshold that was in place at the time for renewable diesel. Now, at the time, there was no company in the U.S. even contemplating renewable diesel production. There was nothing in the works, much less RD production using canola oil. So at the time, it was decided to go ahead with the analysis that had been looked at by the EPA and just have canola approved for biodiesel use. Now that EPA assured us that they would likely okay it in time, but they haven't. So now there's an ongoing shift in the biofuels market towards more renewable diesel production. Production of renewable diesel has been up more than 46% in the last year alone. So we've asked the EPA to complete its assessment that they've had on their desk for the last decade and complete that analysis, which we believe will show that canola oil meets the higher threshold to be included as an eligible feedstock for renewable diesel production. Now, this would allow a local source of renewable diesel production in North Dakota, the plant in South Hart, for instance, to be able to add canola oil to its list of eligible commodities that could be used. And this would fit well with our target objective of finding new uses for canola oil. Finally, we hope by this winter that things will return to normal, and we plan on having our 23rd annual Canola Expo in Langdon on Tuesday, December 8th. And as always, we encourage growers who want to become members of the association to just log on to our website at northerncanola.com, where you can click on website link to become a member of the association. We look forward to seeing you at our Canola Expo in Langdon on Tuesday, December 8th. Thank you.